So when you think of keyboard shortcuts on your Mac, usually you think about how they interact with the Finder or with different apps. But you can also sometimes interact with different things such as YouTube videos on a web page. There's a whole set of custom keyboard shortcuts that work with those. And those are built into the YouTube videos themselves. They're not something special on your Mac. So let's take a look at an example. I'm going to look at a video on the MacMost site. So this is an embedded video that is part of a web page. But the same thing will be true if you use YouTube videos at the YouTube site as well. So you can see here I'm playing the video. You want to get it going. First use keyboard shortcuts. And you got the controls at the bottom. Also, the keyboard focus, which is where the keystrokes go when you press a key, may actually be on the web page, not the actual video itself. So you want to make sure before you use keyboard shortcuts that the last thing you did was click on the video in some way. So clicking on it to keep it going and pausing it. Now I know the focus is on the video. So some things are really obvious. Like for instance spacebar to play or pause. So I can hit spacebar here and you can see it continues playing. And I can hit spacebar again to pause. Another thing you could do is you can jump around in the video using the arrow keys. So if I move the, use the arrow keys, the right one and the left one. In this case I had the volume selected. So let's go back to playing there. The right arrow key you can see will move forward by 5 seconds. So 26 seconds, 31 seconds, 36 seconds. And the left arrow key by 5 in the other direction. Now there's also the ability to use the J, K, and L keys. The K key will also pause and resume just like the spacebar. And the J and L keys will go forward by 10 seconds or backwards by 10 seconds. So you can kind of use those keys. You can put 3 fingers over them and quickly jump around in the video. Likewise, you can use the number keys at the top of your keyboard to jump to a portion of the video. For instance, pressing 1 will move to 10% in the video. 5 will move to the middle, 9 will move to 90%, and 0 will move all the way back to the beginning. Now you can easily jump into full screen mode with F and use F to jump out of full screen mode, or the escape key will work for that as well. You can also go and change the volume using the up and down arrow keys. So watch the volume change. And if I actually move the cursor over here you can see it going. It's actually muted right now. So I'm going to hit the M key, another one to unmute. And you can see now I can move it up and down with the up and down arrow keys, and I can M to mute it again. You can speed up the playback of a video actually by using shift and then the period or the comma. Period to speed up, comma to slow down. So let me get it playing here. And I will go shift and then the period, and you can see it's going to speed it up and move pretty quickly. You can see how quickly those seconds are moving. Comma will actually slow it down. I can hit multiple commas there to actually go really slow. So you can see the video is actually moving, but it's going quite slowly. You can, let me pause it with K there, and you can actually use the period and the comma to actually move forward frame by frame, and the comma to move backward frame by frame. In addition to M for mute and unmute, you can use C to turn on captioning. So you can see the captions there at the bottom of the screen. And that pretty much sums up all the different things you can do with keyboard shortcuts. You can really do a lot to control things. You can put your fingers over the J, K, and L keys, or all 4 arrow keys, and have a lot of controls for playing back a video.